In this video, I'll show you how to import contacts into your Mailchimp audience from a file. To prepare your file for import, open a new spreadsheet in a program like Excel or Google Sheets. First, you'll label your columns to match the audience fields in Mailchimp. To successfully import a contact, you'll need to include the field for their primary channel, which is either email address or SMS phone number. If you're only importing text message marketing contacts, you don't have to include an email address as long as you enter their SMS phone number. If you have an SMS plan, but don't have your SMS marketing set up yet, follow these steps. First, log into Mailchimp and visit our SMS page. Then continue to the sending country step of the registration. If Mailchimp's SMS marketing is available in your area, follow the remaining steps to set up a program. And finally, confirm that your contacts have opted into your SMS marketing. Okay, back to the spreadsheet. Remember, a contact has to have an SMS phone number or email address to be imported. Okay, let's keep going. After you've labeled your columns, enter your contact's information. You have to format certain fields in a specific way. For instance, the formatting for SMS phone number will vary by country. To get the best results for your import, review our import file format guidelines. Once you've set up your spreadsheet, save it as one of our supported file types. You can usually find this option in the File menu under Download or Save As. Now, let's open up Mailchimp and import your file. First, click Audience. Then click All Contacts. Next, use the Add Contacts drop-down menu to choose Import Contacts. After that, you'll choose how you want to add your contacts. You can upload a file, copy and paste directly from your spreadsheet, or connect a third-party integration to bring your contacts over. Let's go with Upload a File, then click Continue. Now, you can browse to find your import file on your computer or drag and drop it. When you're done, click Continue to move on to the Organize step. Your contacts will be imported to the audience that's selected. If you have more than one audience, click the Current Audience drop-down to make your choice. If you're importing contacts who opted into receiving text message marketing, make sure your audience is SMS enabled. If you're importing data for contacts who are already in your audience, click the box for Update Any Existing Contacts. For most fields, we'll replace existing data with the new data from your file, fields such as address, phone number, and name. But if you import new tags or groups, you'll still have a record of the original ones in your contacts profile. If you leave this box unchecked, and we find duplicate contacts, we won't import the new data. That's because we try to avoid creating duplicate contacts so they don't count towards your billing. When you're good to go, click Continue to move to the Tag step. Tags are internal labels that help you organize your audience so that you can improve your targeting and personalize your messages. You can use tags to build custom segments to send the right message only to the relevant portions of your audience. For example, maybe you want to send a thank you coupon to the contacts who showed up to your last event. Tags are not visible to your contacts, so do whatever makes sense to you. Just click the drop-down to choose or create tags as needed. I'll enter Marigold Festival, so I can send that coupon just to them. And click Create. Now that I'm all set here, let's click Continue. Here, you'll match the columns in your import file to the fields in your Mailchimp audience. We'll automatically match some columns for you, like email address. But if you need to make adjustments, use the drop-down under Mailchimp's field names to match to a different field or create a new one. Keep in mind, if a column doesn't match a Mailchimp audience field, the data won't be imported. Once you've matched your fields, click Continue. On this screen, you'll select the subscription status for your contacts. The subscribed status means your contacts have given you permission to market to them. If you assign the subscribed status to your SMS contacts, click the checkbox to confirm you've received their consent. And we're almost done. When you're ready for the last step, click Finalize Import. Now, take some time to review the details of your import. This is a good time to double-check the details of your plan on our pricing page. When you import contacts, it affects your total contact count. If you do go over your plan's limit, you could receive an additional charge. Once everything looks good, click Complete Import. Nice work. Now you'll have a chance to review any errors that popped up during the import. We'll also send a notification to the email address associated with your account, and we'll include links to resources to help you troubleshoot your specific issues. From the email, you can follow a link to the All Contacts page, where you can filter your contacts by tags and segments. Well done! You've imported contacts into Mailchimp from a file. If you want more information about how to organize, manage, and grow your audience, visit our Help Center or YouTube channel.